have something to share with you from my own experience and from experience of my clients. I'm not sure that I will speak a lot of new things for you. I think that a lot of this stuff you have already know, but I will try to show it in some interesting way that was useful for me to understand other businesses and to create some new ideas and redesign some services and products of my clients. Okay, so let's start. First, I will speak a few words about myself. I'm really an entrepreneur. In my mind, I'm a business designer. I design different products and services for my clients, and I'm a producer of digital projects. It's like a person who care about the money or the business. So for me, it was very, very important to understand the whole thing of product and services creation. So, several years ago, I founded Expert Network. It was a kind of new type of organization where we have a worldwide network of IT experts, and we gather them for complex solutions for our clients. And we don't own people, we just make connections with the best of them and gather really, really good teams. If you want, you will see my cases in the internet later. So, for these years, I worked with clients. You can see some logos in this screen. They were very different. It was innovative and old school. It was like government and different kind of them. And we have a very good experience and know very interesting things. And what I knew from my clients building products and services for these years. I will speak maybe about you have already known, but don't hurry to make conclusions before I go to the end of 72 slides, because I think that we make it very quick, because it's for my speech, it's not for reading or for watching this. I think it will be interesting. So what I knew from my clients and what I see the problem, what problems I see in this. The first, it's hard for people to explain ideas in a simple way. 100 times I met somebody who told me, I have a great idea, I have something new, I have something very interesting, and they couldn't explain a simple way what it was. So the second is, they have different focuses and experience. When you work with a team, when you have the board and around the table, all the people have a different background. These guys from sales, these guys from marketing, these guys from finance, and they all built one product on, they built for one task, and they really speak different languages inside teams. So for me and for my colleagues, it was a real problem, because when you speak with one guy, he tell you one thing. There's another guy, he tell you another thing, and all they speaking about one problem, project, and about one product, about something that they want you to create for them and to help to create for them. So that was really, really hard for us to understand what people want, because they don't really understand what they want and what they do mostly. So, and it's really hard to create new products when everything changes all the time. So I think it's very important to understand that now we are in unique circumstances, because everything changes, becomes new technology, and they shape all the business, and they shape products, and they shape everything. And we'll speak about it today, and how to build and how to make stuff in this in these conditions. So from this, I can say that we need something smart and simple to think about business, to think about products and services, and we need special language to share with all the teams and all the teammates. And what it could be. And to draw the line, I will start from the from the past and will go to the Industry 4.0. I'm sure you know what it is, but let's look some retrospective. So it's a current trend of automation and data exchange in manufacturing technologies, and it's all about what is happening now. So how it was, look at the pictures and understand that after all these inventions, our lives have changed, and all the industry changes make new possibilities and new way of doing business and doing jobs of us, of all of us. So in the beginning it was steam power, then it was electrical power, then it was electronic and IT to automate production, and now we are here. It's the use of cyber physics systems to monitor, analyze and automate business. So my focus in this area. So what does it mean for all of us? We live in a very interesting world, and we need to think how it will change 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, and we need to shape our business, to shape our communications, our products and services, and how to make it. Because it's not a joke, but many people can lose their jobs in several years, and we must understand how it will be and how we need to change. But to say the world has changed is to say nothing. Let's look at what is inside of this. The part of Industry 4.0 is digital transformation. It's a building of a new economy. It's you understand how important it is and how important to understand what digital transformation make with all of us. So it is the changes associated with the application of digital technology in all aspects of human society, and this is my key interest, because all our clients want to transform their business, to transform their services, companies, or to create something new in the industry they work in. And for CEO and for top managers, it's really hard to understand which point to start, from which point to start to redesign their companies, to redesign the future of their companies. So, I don't know if it's possible to see the video. Let's try. If not, it's okay. Will it be sound? No? No? Okay. It can be without sound, because a lot of letters there. So we must understand that no more way to stay as it was earlier in our business, and we need to transform it, because good enough is not enough. You must be something new, something incredible, something more than others, to get your clients' attention. So you see all these words and you see all these theses, and it's clear, but what to do with them, how to use this information in changing, in shaping of your companies. So let's go down. Okay, and so one moment. Как звук выключить здесь? How to turn it on? Yes, and I will tell about a couple of things that really change our life and business. It's first, it's big data. It helps to make services cheaper and more useful. It's blockchain. I think that everybody hear it every day in blockchain, Bitcoin, and everything is connected with this. And it's success factors that everybody need to understand. It's business model, innovation, ecosystems, and startup DNA. And the most interesting thing for me is business model innovation, and we speak about it today. And if it is interesting for you, we can get some practice tomorrow. So people, culture, and organization need to be changed. And with Agile Manifesto, many companies go this way, but not many people really understand what Agile mean and what is the difference between Agile and Scrum. And the mess of these modern words disappoint a lot of people, a lot of companies, and they all want to be Agile, they all want to have Scrum, but what for? What else? What for? And we'll try to explain. So before I try to explain, let's see at the slide what is happening now. So digital affecting all the industries, but with different speeds. So as you see, the tourism, media, telecoms, retail, banking, distribution is in the front. So other industries is the second and third. So you can see now that winner takes it all in dynamics. So let's remember that we have some phenomenal things that we have. We can see Facebook. It's a huge capitalization. It's the biggest media company that does not create content. It's Uber that does not have own cars, and Airbnb does not have houses or flats, but they're very, very big companies with very, very big capitalization. So the world has changed forever, and then we can see the new economy landscape. Now I will show you some slides for just to feel the changes. Education technology landscape, just see that a lot of companies use new technology to change the industry in education. It's a lot of student learning practice programs and theories now, and it's very important to understand how it will change. So the second is Bitcoin and blockchain. It's really, really hype now, and it's a really bubble, but it's for us it's important to understand how it works, and we need to use it in our product and services to add more value in our stuff. Yeah, okay. So a lot of companies all over the world use this technology to build companies and services. Virtual reality, it's one of new trends. Just look at the landscape. Don't try to see all the icons. Just look at this time. What it's all the new. It was not impossible 5 years ago. So virtual reality is very, very good perspective. So it's digital hospital. It's the next thing that will be changed. A lot of companies making new things in these areas. So it's all about transformation. It's all about digital transformation, which is part of Industry 4.0. You can Google all this in internet, and you'll find all these landscapes. It's very interesting to understand which part of this landscape company is divided in, because it can give you some more insights to starting new business, starting new services, and so on. So artificial intelligence. So it's very good with big data and blockchain. So 3D printing. It's one of the trends in education that in close 10 years it will be the do-it-yourself culture, when all the school and the university will have their 3D printers, and they will make stuff for them. And I think that in your homes it will be too, because it will be simple and useful. You will buy products with one side, and another side you will print at your home. It will be like a new business model. Now, all we speak about today, all we speak about is about business model, and I know that a lot of people know the canvas, you know, a lot of people know about the books, but never implemented in business, as I understand. A lot of people, I know canvas, I see canvas, but I don't know how to implement it in the work of company. We speak about it. So intelligent assistance landscape is also very interesting for us to understand what is changing and how to use this in our products and services. So bots landscape. You see so many good stuff. You see so many services, so many companies, so many so many sectoral nuances. So a lot of stuff, big data landscape. Just see it, this company, it's a new business model. They have do something new. It's very, very interesting to understand all of this. Applications, industry, healthcare, life science, transportation, commerce, and other, everything. Big data is really, really strong thing. So most people perceive changes in the world as a reality, while the most enterprising and attentive earn of this state. So let's be one of them, and how to make it. We'll speak about it now. What is it from? Who knows? It is from Alice in Wonderland, and it's the author of this book. So let's start from here. In the center you see the business, all the business, and we see that it is under pressure of four key factors. I had not enough time to prepare English picture, but I will explain what it is. In the top of this, it's key tendencies. In the left of this is sectoral factors, and in the right, market factors, and in the down, macroeconomic factors. All the business are making his stuff under pressure of these factors. And let's see where the digital transformation come from. It has come from here. All the technologies and all the landscapes, all the companies come from here. And if you understand how it changes, what part of business it change, you can redesign, or you can create something new. But it's not the end. The second thing is that digital transformation don't come alone. It come with the changing of market factors. Yeah. So if some technology come in our life, there are people that become use it. The user of it, just see on this guy, just see on these devices. It's all for people. It's really, really useful for them. I use one of this stuff in Moscow. I use it in my car with me. So just see how many devices in this field. Yeah. And the second one, that it changed sectoral factors. When digital transformation comes, when you have some key tendencies, it shapes your market factors and also sectoral factors. You will notice that there are companies that in your field, and they are new, and they are smart, and they are small, not so big as your companies, and they really can disturb you in the future. So what we see? We see that in the center of this thing, there is a business model. Who use business model canvas in their job? Who use it? Who know it? Who use it? Why? I'm always wonder why people know about this weapon and they don't use it, because for me it's a key tool, and for me and for my company and for my clients it's a key tool to understand what is happening around them and how to shape and how to redesign their services and products. So to see this picture, you can understand that if we have digital transformation here, so we changed this part of the business model. If we see changes here, it changes this part of the business model. And if you have changes here, you will think about this part. We don't speak about macroeconomic factors now because it's very important too, but it's not our key opinion. So what I want to say? I want to say that to start making products and services of new next generation, you must understand the context of your business. And to use this tool, you can do very, very quick. Do it very, very quick. If I will have time, I will show you how I implemented one with one of my clients. So what we can say, so I know that it's not new for us, but I want to pay attention to this. From the competition of goods and services, the world turns to competition of business models. So it's important not what you do, but how you do. It's about that how you create value for each segment of your audience. And it's like designing of sense of your business. If you understand it simple and you can simple translate it to people, to other people, it will work, and a lot of people will use it. If you cannot explain it in simple words, and people will not get it. So I introduce this guy. He's Alex Osterwalder. He's invented the business model canvas and co-founded strategizer.com. And he's a very interesting guy. I know him by the email, and one of my clients, I discovered the canvas for one of my clients, and they came to the New York, and he told him about me, and we had dropped alliance together. He's a really, really smart guy. So what he did, he made this book. Who has this book in his library? Mm-hmm. Who have read this book? Nobody. Three person. Really read from the beginning to end? No. Okay. Thank you for true. Who have read the book? It's about 5 years. 5-6 years. So just I want you to read this book, because your life will be more simple and more effective. So I can say that business model can be used not only in business. You can make your business model or business model non-profit organization. It works the same. It's a very interesting tool. Okay. So it's not one tool. It's they have two tools, and they are combined. This tool is value proposition canvas, is integrated in business model canvas. It's the only two tool that you can use to redesign and to shape your business. I know that you use different tools, different practice. Somebody like rice, somebody like some other stuff. And this guy, why I like and why I use it, because he aggregated all these tools and all these topics in one simple, clear framework that adapted for big companies. So if you work in big companies, you need to understand that it's very important to speak this language. Okay. So tomorrow I will speak about it in practice way. We'll describe all these blocks, and I will show how to use it, and I will help you to make a skill of use it, because it's very simple. It's you have only nine blocks, and if you remember this order, you will speak about business model simple. You can describe any business model. You can make hypotheses and so on. So the first important thing is customer segments. It's very important to understand which segments you divide your customer. And it's a very big problem in companies, in big banks, in IT companies. It's a very, very big problem to make right segmentation. Because if you have a mistake in segmentation, all your business model failed. If you don't understand the segments and what is the jobs to be done, you cannot help them. You cannot be useful for them. And about useful, we need to understand people different way. We need to understand it not about how old am I, who am I, and where I work. We need to understand a lot of more things. So, and we need to be useful. We need to be useful. Every company need to be useful. You need to understand what is useful, what you make useful for people, why they choose you. And it is from that context of business and one from your business model. So this is the value proposition canvas. It's integrated in business model you see in the top. So when we speak about customer segments, we need to divide it in customer jobs, which is connected with customer gains and customer pains. So you need to read it this first, this second, this third, or this first, this second, this third. So to understand your people, you can clearly and simple, in a simple way, create the value for them. And if it is fitted and work in the business model, so it's already good for your clients. So I invite you to connect our team to have some practical skills tomorrow for a workshop, and we'll see how people make business model, and we'll try to make business model of your perspective services and products, and I will help you to understand the tool more and to have a skill to implement it in your daily job. Thank you. I will be very glad to answer your questions. Sorry for my English, sorry for my maybe mess of words, but I tried to be useful for you. Thank you. How I came to this, I want a little, how I came to this tool, as what it was for me, what problem I had. A lot of people came to me and they asked me to do different stuff, yeah? And for me it was very hard how to work with different clients in the same day, in the same week, with very, very different companies and tasks. And this tool helped me to make all this complex simple. And I highly recommend you to read these books and to have the skill of business modeling. It's very important right now. Maybe some years ago it wasn't so clear, but now it's about to change or die. We need to change.
Okay, so any questions or any thoughts?
Thank you for the presentation. There are a couple of variations on business model canvas, right? One of the most popular being lean business model canvas. How do you recommend that, which is like either the right one, and if not, are there like applications for each one? Okay. Well, maybe one is more for corporations and one is more for startups.
Okay, thank you for the question. I really think that the power of Canvas, business model Canvas, is in the combining of with value proposition Canvas and with the vision of context business. In this case, it's more, how to say it, it's a good pact for working with companies and for with people. So if you see this variation of canvases, they are not connected with other tools and they don't work together. Understand? Two connected tools, and this is one tool. You can use it, but you cannot so much benefits that you can from that.
Any questions? Who else? Maybe.
If you have some time, I show you one video I like. It is not sound here, but just see how people use Canvas to describe business ideas and to think about new business models and about new products and services. It's very interesting. You can use it today. You don't need anything to start using it. So you can Google, you can watch some video, you can make like this with your team tomorrow, today. So, okay, it's the company Xiaomi. I will speak about it. And they bought the company Yuku to do. So why? Let's see what they wanted. It's a very successful company. They have increasing sales, and they're a smartphone production company. It's their core business. So they use the segments who need mobile phones. They sell it through e-commerce and through telecom operators who are their partners. And they pay for the smartphone It's a type of revenue stream. And it's the core business. I need to say that business model is the tool where you need to focus only the things that matters. You don't need to write that we need project manager. It goes without saying. Only the canvas is the field only for things that matters. So you can describe it like this. So the partners is Google and Android, about operating systems of Xiaomi, and they make activity in social networks to promote it. So, and here they started to think about new products and services, and they understood that it will be the time when a lot of people will have smartphones and their sales will not grow as now, and they need something new to have revenue streams, and they decided to make this thing. You will see now. It's just a story for 2 minutes that show how people reinvent their model. So when you buy a smartphone, what you do? You download applications. And so they understood that it's a huge opportunity for them. So if they sell phone, they can make applications, they can make content and to sell it to people. So it's very interesting. So they bought company that made content development, and they bought Youku to do, and they add key resources on web development team or content development team. But for what? But why? Because, as I said, when you sell smartphone and people download application, you can sell them video content and have another type of revenue stream. So this is how you can reinvent your business model. So they observed their context. They understood what is key tendencies. They understood how these key tendencies will shape the market. And they create this. So if you're interested in this, please come tomorrow. We make it together. Thank you.
Thank you.